Hodder and Stoughton presents Intermediate Russian. Learn Russian with the Michel Thomas Method. Taught by Natasha Bershadski.
Welcome to your intermediate course with the Michel Thomas Method. During this course, you'll build on your knowledge of the language already acquired in the foundation course, and you'll learn to express yourself using an even wider range of structures and vocabulary. Once again, please ensure you listen to the course in a calm, stress-free environment. This will help you to retain the information naturally. And at all times, the teacher will be here to guide and prompt you through the learning process. Playing an active role in the course will be essential for your language to develop. Just as in the foundation course, you'll be joined by two students who are learning the language for the first time, just like you. You're the third student. So when the teacher asks, "How would you say?" use the pause button on your playing device to think about what the answer should be. Then say the answer out loud and release the pause button. You'll then hear the student's response and then the phrase repeated by a native speaker. As we'll be steadily building on language you already know, we hope that you'll feel a constant sense of progress and that you'll find this an exciting and stimulating approach to developing your language.
In this course, we will together continue to build the structure of the Russian language. We will assemble it logically and effortlessly. We're also going to cement all the parts so that the structure is stable and strong, because you want to keep it for life. Can you translate my sentence, please? Вы готовы? What did I say? Вы готовы?
Are you ready?
Mm-hmm. Да. Вы готовы? Yes, I'm ready.
Да, я готов.
Mm-hmm. That's what a man says. Да, я готов. And what does a woman say?
Да, я готова.
Да, я готова. Mm-hmm. How do you say, I'm ready to speak Russian?
Я готова говорить по-русски.
Да, хорошо. Я готова говорить по-русски. And what does a man say?
Я готов говорить по-русски.
Mm-hmm. Очень хорошо. The word for glad or happy is rad. Just three letters there. Rad. And this word will change in exactly the same way as the word that you've just used, готов. So how do you say, he is glad?
Он рад.
Да, конечно, он рад. And she is glad?
Она рада.
Of course, она рада. And we are glad?
Мы рады.
Mm-hmm. Мы рады. What is the verb to see? Remember video?
Видит.
Mm-hmm. Видит.
Видит.
Accented on E. Видит. So how do you say, I'm very glad to see you?
Я очень рад.
And you are a woman.
Я очень рада.
Mm-hmm. You.
Вас видит.
Very good. Я очень рада вас видеть. We are glad to see you.
Мы рада.
You said мы.
Oh,
follow
sorry.
This.
Мы рады
mm-hmm.
вас видеть.
Да, конечно. Мы рады вас видеть. How would you say he is glad to see me?
Он рад меня видеть.
Да. Он рад меня видеть. Mm-hmm. And she's glad to see.
Она рада меня видеть.
Хорошо. Она рада меня видеть. Очень хорошо. In the present tense, you've got two groups of verbs. Е verbs that have Е in the ending, and you've got E verbs that have E in the ending. Most verbs that end with at in the to form are Е verbs. Like, for instance, to know.
Знать.
Знать, to know. To think.
Думать.
Думать. To do.
Делать.
Делать, хорошо. To work.
Работать.
Работать. Mm-hmm. Да. And one more, to understand.
Понимать.
Accented on the ending.
Понимать.
Хорошо. Понимать, to understand. So all these verbs are е verbs. Yes, in the present tense. So how do you say, I understand you, but you don't understand me?
Я понимаю. Я вас понимаю.
Mm-hmm. But?
Но вы меня не понимаете.
Я вас понимаю, но вы меня не понимаете. Mm-hmm. Right? And how do you say, we work here, or we are working here, which is the same?
Мы здесь работаем.
Now, ем is the ending, and the word for work is...
Работать.
Yes, to work is работать. So...
Работаем.
Работа remains, and you add ем.
Работаем.
Хорошо. Работаем. Will you say the sentence again?
Мы здесь работаем.
Очень хорошо. Мы здесь работаем. My computer is not working.
Мой компьютер не работает.
Очень хорошо. Мой компьютер не работает. Mm-hmm. And how do you say the computers are not working? Plural. All plural nouns and almost all.
Компьютеры?
Uh-huh.
Are not working?
Mm-hmm.
Не работай.
And it's plural. They work. Let's go back to I work. How do you say I work?
Я работаю.
Да. And they work, you just add one more letter for they form.
Они работают.
Конечно.
The
они...
T on mm-hmm. the end.
Will you say it once again?
Они работают. Компьютеры работают.
Mm-hmm. Компьютеры работают. Yes. And your previous sentence was они работают, which is what?
They're working.
They are working, yes.
Не работают, we were saying, weren't we?
It's okay. They are working, они работают. They are not working, они не работают. How do you say, I am glad that now the computers are working?
Я рада.
Рада.
Рада, что компьютер...
I said computers, didn't I?
Компьютеры работают.
Now.
Сейчас.
Yes, you can play. If you forget the word, you can place it at the end. Word order is free. Mm-hmm. Now, will you try to change word order?
Я рада, что компьютеры сейчас работают.
Хорошо. They work well.
Хорошо.
And quickly.
И быстро.
Quickly, again.
Быстро.
Right, быстро. Mm-hmm. Я рада, что компьютеры сейчас работают. Хорошо и быстро. Mm-hmm. Right, that was the first group of words, the year verbs in the present. Now, the e verbs is a smaller group. To speak, what is to speak?
I can only think of спешит.
Спешит, what is спешит? Sounds like спешит, species, human species. How are they different from all the rest of the species?
They hurry.
They hurry.
Hurry.
This is to hurry. Спешит is to hurry. By the way, it's also an e verb, isn't it? And what is to speak? It's...
Gavrit.
Uh-huh. Да. How did you remember that? I know how. Because governments speak a lot, don't they? Gavrit, to speak. Yes, and спешит, to hurry. How do you say, we speak Russian and English?
Мы говорим
uh-huh.
по-русски и по-английски.
Хорошо. Мы говорим по-русски и по-английски. Well.
Хорошо.
And quickly.
И быстро.
Right. Мы говорим по-русски хорошо и быстро. What are you saying? Or what are you speaking?
Что вы говорите?
Uh-huh, да. Что вы говорите? Да. I don't understand what you are saying.
Я не знаю...
That is, I don't know.
Я не пачи...
It's a pony.
Я не понимаю, что вы говорите.
Да. Говорите. Say it again,
что
please.
Вы говорите.
The whole thing.
Я не понимаю, что вы говорите.
Угу, uh-huh, да. Я не понимаю, что вы говорите. Хорошо. There was another verb, another e-verb, to see. What is to see?
Видеть.
Uh-huh. Видеть. Видеть. Yes. How do you say I see? And in I see, the D becomes Ж, like in vision rather than video. Yes? I see?
Я вижу.
Я?
Stressful. Вижу.
Да. Я вижу. And we see?
Мы вижу.
It's Д in the other forms. Видео.
Видим.
It's an E verb.
Видим?
Yes, only you
Мы
don't accent.
Видим.
Right, you don't accent it, but it yeah. is E. Мы видим. We see. What can you see or what do you see in Russian?
Что вы видите?
Mm-hmm, да. Что вы видите? What do you see? What can you see? I'm sorry, I can't see anything. Anything, nothing. I can't see nothing.
Извините. Я не вижу, вижу ничего.
Да. Or will you change the word order now?
Извините. Я ничего вижу.
Negative.
Не вижу.
Очень хорошо. Извините, я ничего не вижу. Double negative. I don't see nothing is a norm in Russian. Я ничего не вижу. How do you say I want?
Я хочу.
Да. Я хочу. And this is one verb that couldn't decide whether it wants to be a е verb and or и verb, right? And it's split in half. Singular е, plural и. So, I don't know what he wants.
Я не знаю, что он хочет.
Or is accented.
Хочет.
Хочет. Хорошо. Я не знаю, что он хочет. I don't know what he wants to say. To say?
Говорить.
That's to speak.
No.
And to say?
Сказать.
Ага, сказать. So, I don't know what he wants to say.
Я не знаю, что он хочет сказать.
Да, хорошо. Я не знаю, что он хочет сказать. What do you want to find out? What's to find out?
Узнать.
Mm-hmm. Узнать. What do you want to find out?
Что вы хотите узнать?
Очень хорошо. Что вы хотите узнать? What do you want to find out? Right. That was the present. You also know the future. The future that you know is formed with the help of Buddha. Yes, and this Buddha changes just like the verbs in the present that we have done with you. Yes, so no new endings here. Plus, you have the to form of the verb. So, how do you say, I will speak?
Я буду сказ... Have I got the wrong one?
Speak.
Говорить.
Да.
Я буду говорить.
Да. Я буду говорить. Right. And he will speak?
Он будет... Говорить.
Хорошо. Он будет говорить, да. And we will speak.
Мы будем говорить.
Мы будем говорить, yes. Now this Buddha will also means will be. I will be at home.
Я буду дома.
Да. Mm-hmm. Хорошо. Я буду дома. And how do you say, I will have tea. I will drink tea. I will have tea. In Russian, just I will.
Я буду чай.
Да.
Я буду пить чай.
Очень хорошо. Either я буду чай on its own or я буду пить чай. Пить, to drink. Очень хорошо. Now the past. The past is very easy. The verbs in the past don't look like verbs. In the present, they look like what? They look like nouns. They have the same endings as nouns. Only they have the l. Before the ending. So, how do you say he said and not spoke?
Он сказал.
Да, он сказал. And she said?
Она сказала.
Она сказала. And we said?
Мы сказали.
Да, мы сказали. Excuse me, what did you say?
Извините, что вы сказали?
Mm-hmm, хорошо. Извините, что вы сказали? I want... I can and I will speak Russian well. Yes, I want.
Я хочу.
I can.
Я могу.
И... And I will.
Я буду говорить по-русски хорошо.
Я хочу, я могу, и я буду говорить по-русски хорошо. Now we'll go back to the verb to eat. How do you say I want to eat? Or you can say I'm hungry.
Я хочу есть.
Yes, есть. Now soft.
Есть.
Да. Я хочу есть. I want to eat, literally. Or in English you can say I'm hungry. That's the meaning of the English sentence and of the Russian sentence. Now, in English, you can also say I want to have a meal. Yes? Both to eat and to have a meal mean more or less the same thing. It's all about eating, isn't it? In Russian, you also have a means of expressing this. Only, as very often happens in Russian, it's all in one word. So instead of using four words in English to have a meal, you use just one word in Russian, just one verb. And that verb is very similar to the verb есть, only you add a prefix in front. The prefix is по, and it becomes поесть. So you have two verbs for to eat in Russian, есть and поесть. The second one, поесть, is equivalent to the English to have a meal, or probably to have something to eat, or to have a bite. Yes? So it's есть, поесть. So when you're just hungry, you say what?
Я хочу есть.
Я хочу есть. But when you ask a question, where can one have a meal? It's also about eating, but it's more concrete now. You would use the verb поесть. Where can one have a meal?
Где?
What is the word for one can or it is possible? One may.
Можно.
Можно. So where is it possible to have a meal?
Где можно поесть?
Где можно поесть? Where can I have a meal? Now, how do you say to have a nice meal? Again, in English, it is to have a nice meal. And in Russian, it's to eat well, using the same verb. So to have a nice meal.
Хорошо поесть.
Yes, хорошо поесть. So how do you ask the question? Where can one have a nice meal?
Где можно хорошо поесть?
Yes, that's your question. It sounds very different from the English question, but it expresses the same idea. Где можно хорошо поесть? How do you ask the question, where can one have a quick meal? That is, eat quickly.
Где можно быстро поесть?
Yes. Где можно быстро поесть? Where can one have a quick meal? Eat quickly.
Is that поесть a prefix that can be applied to any other words usefully?
To many other verbs, but not all of them, as you will see. Now, what is the verb to drink?
Пить.
Пить. Yes. There is an equivalent to this verb as well. All Russian verbs come in pairs. Most of them will have a prefix in the second verb. But the prefixes, unfortunately, are different. По is one of the popular ones, but with the verb to drink, it'll be a different prefix. And the prefix will be вы, and it will be accented. How do you form the verb?
Выпить.
Да, выпить. So you have two verbs now, пить and выпить. How do you say I want to drink? That's something that you've said before.
Я хочу пить.
Yes. Я хочу пить. I want to drink, or I'm thirsty. That's about your general condition state of being thirsty. Yes, I want to drink. Я хочу пить. But in English, you can also say, I want to have a drink. Or you can say, I want to have a coffee. Again, in Russian, it's just this one verb with вы. So, how do you say to have coffee or to have a coffee?
Выпить кофе.
So, I want to have a coffee.
Я хочу выпить кофе.
Да. Я хочу выпить кофе. And I want to have a tea.
Я хочу выпить чай.
Да. Я хочу выпить чай.
Does it apply to beer and wine and vodka and water?
Of course.
Yeah.
You want to say that you want to have a beer.
Я хочу выпить пиво.
Right. Я хочу выпить пиво. Mm-hmm. So, for the verbs to eat and to drink, you have a pair for each in Russian. To eat, есть, поесть. To drink, пить, выпить. Right.
So, the ones with the prefix effectively more emphatic form of the basic pizza, yeast.
You call it emphatic. I would call it a one-time thing, a more concrete thing, rather than wanting to eat in general, you want a meal, rather than being thirsty, wanting to drink, you want a drink, and so on. So each of Russian verbs has a pair. Let's take the verb to think. What is to think?
Думать.
Думать, yes. And думать, its pair, will be the same prefix, по, as with поесть. So you have two, думать and
по, подумать.
Да, you have думать, подумать. Yes, in English you can say to think, but you can also say to have a think about it, or give it a thought. That's the idea. So how do you say I need to think, meaning I need to give it a thought?
У меня надо.
It is to me needed. You have me and you have to me.
Меня.
Меня is me and to me.
У меня.
Is by me and to me.
Мне.
Да. Мне. You've said all of them. Меня, me, мне, to me. So, I need to give it a thought is to me needed.
Мне надо подумать.
Да. Мне надо подумать, accent у.
So that would be if someone says, I need to know this, you want to say, I need to think about it.
I need to think about it, exactly. I need to give it a thought, I need to have a think about it. All of this, just one verb, подумать. How do you say, we need to think about this? We need to us, needed.
Нам надо подумать.
Да, нам надо подумать. We need to give it a thought to think about it. How do you say time to think? Meaning time to think something over. What's time?
Время.
To think it over.
Подумать.
Yes. Время подумать. Mm-hmm. So how do you say you have time to think? You have time to think it over. You have time to think about it. You have?
У нас.
Mm-hmm. That's we have and you have.
У вас.
Mm-hmm. There is.
Есть время подумать.
Да. У вас есть время подумать. How do you say we have time to think it over?
У нас есть
time.
Время подумать.
Да. У нас есть время подумать. We have time to think it over. Да. And how do you say, you will have time to think? So, you have, what is you have?
У вас.
Mm-hmm. And there is?
Есть.
Yes, that is you have. And you will have?
У вас будете.
But this Buddha has the ending of он. What's the он ending of?
Будет.
Yes. So, you will have.
I have to ask why.
Why is it this form of the
why is
verb?
The you? You said you will have.
Yes, but that's in English. You say you will have. And in Russian it is by you. And it does
there
not.
There will be, yes.
Yes, and okay. The verb does not go with you. It goes with the word time.
Right.
And time is equivalent to it, which is in Russian the same as on, она, or оно.
Okay.
So.
У вас будет время подумать.
Да, хорошо. У вас будет время подумать. You will have time to think it over. What is to do?
Делать.
Mm-hmm. Делать, yes. Делать also has a pair, as practically all Russian verbs. So, делать, its pair, has a different prefix, is just one letter, с, and it's сделать. So, the pair is делать, сделать, both to do, Or сделать can be equivalent to the English to have something done. In English, you have to do or to be doing and to have something done. So, how do you ask the question, what needs to be done?
Что надо сделать?
Да.
Is that all?
Yeah, that's all.
Oh.
Three words. Что надо сделать? What needs to be done? This needs to be done quickly.
Это надо сделать быстро.
Very good. Это надо сделать быстро. How do you say, I want to do it now? Which is, I want to have it done now.
Я хочу сделать...
This?
That's... Это...
Now. Now is when...
Час.
Час is hour and you...
Сейчас.
Okay. Say it again, please.
Я хочу это сделать сейчас.
Very good. Я хочу это сделать сейчас. Very good. And I liked your word order, too. Yes, you have the feeling now of where to put this little word.
It's just so I don't forget it later.
Well, that's a good reason, too, isn't it? And how do you ask the question, can this be done now? Can be possible to do? Start with this.
Это можно сделать сейчас?
Mm-hmm. Are you asking the question or are you making a statement? That was a statement, a good one. Now ask about it. And what is the word you are asking about? Is it
can be done?
No, is it possible?
Это можно сделать сейчас?
Very good. Хорошо. Это можно сделать сейчас? Mm-hmm. Can it be done now? Or is it possible to do it now? Or can I do it now? Or somebody else? Mm-hmm. One needs to think about it.
Another...
One needs is very impersonal. You don't even mention anybody. Just...
Another.
Okay. One needs or it is necessary. So one needs to give it a thought.
Надо подумать.
Mm-hmm. Подумать. Excellent. Again.
Надо подумать.
Yes. Надо подумать. One needs to think or I need to think about it. Yes. So, how do you say one needs to think when it can be done?
Надо подумать, когда можно сделать.
This.
Это сделать.
Okay. Хорошо. Надо подумать, когда можно это сделать. Yes. Try это in a different place.
Надо подумать, когда это можно сделать.
Very good.
Сделать.
Хорошо. Надо подумать, когда это можно сделать.
Can we very quickly go through some mm-hmm. of those question words? Because
right.
I'm forgetting
okay.
когда.
Right. What is where?
Где?
Где? When?
Когда?
Когда? Mm-hmm. What else did we have?
What?
So what?
Что?
Что? Mm-hmm. Why? You ask why when your knowledge is patchy.
Почему?
Почему? How?
Как?
Как? Mm-hmm. How do you say one needs to think, or one needs to think over, how this can be done? Needs. Needed.
Надо подумать, как это сделать.
Possible.
Это можно сделать.
Right, but both variants are in use. Надо подумать, как это можно сделать. One needs to think about how this can be done. But you can omit можно, actually. Надо подумать, как это сделать. One needs to think how to do it, how to have it done, instead of how it is possible to have it done. Yes. And how do you say one needs to think where this can be done?
Надо подумать, где делать.
To have it done. Not doing it in general, but having it done. So it's the other verb for to do.
Nada padumats, gdje sdilats.
This.
Это.
Possible. Nada padumats, gdje sdilats это. Or better.
Nada padumats, gdje это sdilats.
Very good. Nada padumats, gdje это сделать. Where to do it. You can also say where it is possible to do it. Где это можно сделать? Now let's take the verb to think. Which verb did we use to think?
Думать.
Думать, yes. It also has a pair. So what's the other verb for to think?
Подумать.
So what's the pair?
Думать, подумать.
Right, only don't accent the prefix.
Думать, подумать.
Да. Думать, подумать. However, the prefix по can be substituted with other prefixes, which you attach to the same думать, and then the meaning of this verb will change. Everybody knows the word перестройка. Перестройка. I'm pronouncing it syllable by syllable. Перестройка. The prefix in this word is пере, four letters. Пере. The meaning of this prefix is transition. That's why it is перестройка, because it is transition from one state to another state, condition. So this is also a prefix that can be added to verbs. And if we add this prefix to the verb to think, which is думать, what is the verb that you get?
Передумать.
Yes, передумать. What do you think will be the meaning of this verb?
Changing one's mind.
Right, of course, transition from one thought to another one. So we've got still another prefixed verb, which is передумать, to change one's mind. How did we say I thought? How does a man say that?
Я думал.
Mm-hmm. Я думал. So how do you say, as a woman, I have changed my mind?
Я передумала.
Very good. Я передумала. How does a man say that?
Я передумал.
Я передумал. I'm sorry, I've changed my mind. How does a man say that?
Извините, я передумал.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And how does a woman say that?
Извините, я передумала.
Да. Извините, я передумала. Excuse me, or I'm sorry, I've changed my mind. I won't have tea, I will have coffee. How does a woman say that?
Извините, я передумала.
Mm-hmm. I'm not having tea. I will not.
Я не буду.
Tea.
Чай.
I will have coffee.
Я буду кофе.
That's right. Now say the whole thing again, please. I'm sorry, I have changed my mind. I am not having tea. I'm having coffee.
Извините, я передумала. Я не буду чай. Я буду кофе.
Да. Извините, я передумала. Я не буду чай, я буду кофе. I'm sorry, I have changed my mind. I'm not having wine, I'm having beer. How does a man say that?
Извините, я передумал. Я буду.
I will not.
Я не буду. What am I not having?
Whatever. Either beer or wine.
Вино. Я не буду вино, я буду водка.
No, I said either wine or beer. Either of these two.
Извините, я передумал.
Mm-hmm.
Я не буду
wine.
Вино.
I will have beer.
Я буду пиво.
Mm-hmm. Good. Пиво. Пиво.
Пиво.
Пиво.
Пиво.
Uh-huh. Very good. Right. So your sentence is... Извините, я передумал. Я не буду вино, я буду пиво.
Why not vodka or water?
Well, if you want vodka or вода, we will learn how to use these words later on in the course. Yes? For the time being, let's stick to masculine and neuter that ends in -о, like пиво and вино, and чай, which is masculine. Consonant ending. Yes, we will deal with a ending words in this position later in the course, very soon actually. Okay.
I'm just confused why chai is ending in a consonant.
Right. Let's go back to our alphabet. Remember the symbol for two letters is the same. It's for E and short E. The symbol for short E is the same with a little top, mm-hmm. yes? And the short E, the reason it is called short E, is the shortened vowel E, but it's so short that it has become a consonant. Instead of E, it's Y, Y, which is called short E, and you pronounce it as a consonant. So chai, ending in this short E, is a consonant sound, and it's a masculine noun for that reason. How do you ask the question? You've changed your mind. Or have you changed your mind?
Oui, perdumali.
Right. Now let's ask the question, have you changed your mind?
Oui, perdumali.
Exactly. Oui, perdumali. Have you changed your mind? Or did you change your mind? Mm-hmm. Why did you change your mind?
Почему вы передумал?
But we plural.
Почему вы передумали?
Да. Почему вы передумали? Let's go back to the verb to do. What is to do?
Делать.
Right. Делать. Good. What do you think will be to redo or to do something again?
Переделать?
Of course. Переделать. So, how do you say this needs to be redone? Done once again.
Это надо быть?
It's just one verb.
Okay. Это надо переделать.
Mm-hmm. Пере, right?
Переделать.
Right. Это надо переделать. Yes. This should be done once again. You should do it once again. How do you say, I want to do it again?
Я хочу переделать это.
Mm-hmm. Say it again.
Я хочу это переделать.
All right, you know where to place it to sound more neutral. Я хочу это переделать. What was the verb to say that we did some time ago?
Говорить.
Говорить is to speak, right? And a different verb, to say, you inflict scars on somebody if you say rude words.
Сказать?
Of course. Сказать is to say. And the verb for to book is заказать. You change the prefix с for за. So it's the prefix за. Заказать is to book or to order. So how do you say to book a taxi?
Сказать.
It's not to say a taxi, but to book. За is the prefix.
Заказать.
За-ка. I'll pronounce it once again, syllable by syllable, this verb. Заказать. Заказать. So, to book a taxi.
Заказать такси.
Mm-hmm. Такси.
Такси.
Да. Заказать такси. How do you say, I want to book a taxi?
Я хочу заказать такси.
Of course. Я хочу заказать такси. And how do you say, I need, one needs to book a taxi?
Надо заказать такси.
Да. Надо заказать такси. All right. And how do you ask, may I, can I, or is it possible to book a taxi?
Можно заказать такси.
Of course. Можно заказать такси. Can I...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.